Garden, in the hollow of a sunken ship, lay the remains of a clockwork seahorse. It must have built and cared for this garden until it finally expired. Although Merin could not fix it, she would do her best to carry on its noble purpose.
Thank you. Thank you.
The scattered remains of a clockwork seahorse lay on the floor amongst the waving strands of glow kelp. It must have once been a guardian for this undersea forest. Merrin would make sure that a part of it would live on within the sea garden. Taking out her tools, Merrin connected the tiny gears and springs, one by one. At last, she saw a glow return to the seahorse's emerald eyes. Beyond the gate, Merrin gasped in awe as she looked up at the face of an elder sea dragon. The graceful giant studied her. Its eyes were older than the Merrows, older even than the Watcher. "I want to help," Merrin said at last. "I'll do anything you ask." And no sooner had she said those words than she saw a vision. She saw how the Fomori had once tamed a giant beast called the Rimorosa. It was a fierce and intelligent creature whose powerful tentacles could kill the largest leviathan in the sea. But it rebelled against the Fomori and drove them away. Now only their machines remain, gradually destroying what is left of the sea. The dreaded Rimarosa, still tormented by the shackles of the Fomori, lives on in the depths below the Forbidden City. It preys on the human vessels above, exacting revenge against those who imprisoned it. Meryn looked back, up into the eyes of the sea dragon, and asked again, "What can I do?" But the sea dragon merely replied, "It is too late. There is nothing left to do." Meryn would not accept this. She would not simply give up. Even if it was too late, she would still try. What if the Rimarosa was somehow connected to the Fomori Sentinels? What if the Rimarosa was causing the destruction of the sea? If she could defeat that terrible beast, it might help to save Kara. If her father was still here, this is what he would do.